The Scottish Parliament has passed many bills bringing about change in Scotland. One of the best known in recent times is this one, the 5p charge for single-use carrier bags.
I'm Nigel Don and I'm the convener of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee of the Scottish Parliament. I'm here to see if I can find anybody who knows how the charge came about.
I'd just like to ask you about the carrier bag charge.
Okay.
Do you know how much you pay?
5 pence.
Do you know why you pay that?
To try and limit the amount of plastic bags that's harming the environment.
And do you know where the charge came from?
No. And because I live in England, I work in England, I'm aware that you don't have to pay it there, so I find it quite irritating.
Do you know how much you pay?
I think it's 5 pence for a bag, isn't it?
Yep, it is. And do you know why you pay it?
I think it's probably to discourage the use of disposable plastic bags because they are bad for the environment.
Yep. Do you know why you pay it?
It's to do a landfill tax.
It is.
There
well done.
Go,
and do you know where the law came from?
Probably England. Well, Great Britain. But there you go. European Union. I've probably had a say in it as well. But that's okay.
In fact, it comes from what we call secondary legislation. This gives us the detail of the law as we know it, which bags are covered and how much we have to pay for them.
The Climate Change Scotland Act gave the Scottish Government the power to make provisions for carrier bag charges in principle. But it was the Single-Use Carrier Bags Charge Scotland regulations of 2014 that actually made provision for carrier bag charges and specified the amount of that charge.
The idea is that the Act enables the Government Minister to introduce the carrier bag charge, but it lays down that the Minister must introduce this piece of secondary legislation and get Parliament to approve the details.
That's where my committee comes in. We scrutinise the secondary legislation, and you might be surprised just how many pieces of secondary legislation affect you, from tax to pensions to education to healthcare, the drink driving limit, even the food we eat.
So secondary legislation isn't just about legal technicalities. It's about getting the detail right as to how the law works for you and me.
You can find out more about secondary legislation and the work of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee through our website.